Hello, I am Test Drive, and welcome to something kind of new and different-ish. Today we are playing DiRT on the PC because DiRT 4 is coming out in about 4 days from now, or 3 days, or 4 days, I don't remember. This Friday, I don't know what day it is, DiRT 4 is coming out, so I figured why not play a little bit of each DiRT game up until that point. This was a random thought I had, and it's 10:30 on whatever night today is. I honestly can't remember it. I don't feel like looking at it. And so we'll be playing this, DiRT 2, and DiRT 3. DiRT Rally won't be included because it's not like, you know, a numbered DiRT. I'll probably play it in the future. Plus, I would have to set up my wheel, which would be... So, yeah, we're just going to take it like a, you know, a 20-minute look at, you know, all of the DiRT games. Unedited. Well, not really unedited, but full on with whatever happens in the video stays in the video. So, as you can tell, as I said, this was a PC version, which actually is really nice. I'm not going to lie. The only problem with the PC version of this game is that it has a disk protector thing where, like, if you have a bootleg disk or something, it won't install it. And sometimes, I think on Windows, I know on Windows 8 it didn't work at all. Luckily on Windows 10 it does work, and I know on Windows XP it does work. Which, you know, who uses XP anymore though, or Vista. But yeah, it looks fantastic. It runs so much better than the Xbox and PS3 versions. Oh my god, it's so much better. So what we are going to be doing, I guess we'll be going into the career, which it appears that I was playing on the second Pro-Am difficulty, judging by the money rewards on the previous two. Pretty simple. I actually did a playthrough of this game, if you guys remember, a couple years ago. 2012, I think, was when I started it. I did a full playthrough of this game on Xbox 360. Which lasted until like 2015, I think, or maybe even 2016, because I got lazy, as I usually do. Yeah, let's not talk about that playthrough. And I always wanted to play through it again on the PC, but I never have gotten around to it, so maybe I'll do that in the future. Who really knows? But, yeah, here's our cars that we can use, a Renault Clio or an Opel Corsa, which I don't have the Opel Corsa, so it looks like the Clio is going to have to do. I kind of want this livery, so I'm going to buy it. Why not? So yeah, I haven't been recording much gaming stuff recently because I've been busy as hell. Why? It just says go. Why does it say go? I don't know. Anyways, let's go ahead and start. Another thing, before I start talking about what I was going to talk about. These loading times. On the Xbox 360 and PS3, this is like half a minute to a minute of loading. And it just loaded in that amount of time on the PC. And that's like any PC too. So, yeah, there we go. Had to remember the correct buttons. But anyways, yeah, uploading has been very limited recently because of being kind of, I guess I could call it busy. It's been a lot of doing stuff with friends and having a social life of some sort. So, oh my god, I almost died there. So, that's my excuse for that. And I've been also working with other behind-the-scenes things that aren't really related to YouTube at all. Although they kind of are, just in a very, very loose way, they're related to YouTube. So, yeah, and real life stuff, also I've been doing, like, real life video stuff. And that's about it. And the vlogging obviously didn't work out because of said busyness and also friends not wanting to be in videos and being with friends constantly, so... Yeah, daily vlogging didn't really work out, and maybe I'm going to try and probably do it in the future, like if I have a weekend of, oh, I'm going to go to this event and stay for a weekend or do this thing and or whatever, like I'll daily vlog then, but for right now, I'm just going to stick with just random stuff that happens probably, maybe, I don't know, depends on if I feel like pulling my camera out or my phone, and yeah, I've already won. Yay me! Yeah, I'm pretty excited for DiRT 4. I haven't really seen much about it. I've heard it's good from people that I trust. So therefore, yeah, this basic, you know, menu stuff. I don't know why I'm just explaining this like this is a brand new game and like, oh, this is this and this is that and that. Just, I'm sure probably everybody knows by now how this game works. So I'll just continue on. But yeah, I've heard that DiRT 4 is pretty good. I don't actually have it pre-ordered yet even. I'll probably buy it the day of. Actually, I'll probably buy it the night before, Thursday night, on PC, and then I'll download it and then play it Friday morning or something. This sucks, because I have to work on Friday. Oh, I pressed the wrong button again. So, maybe I'll be able to wake up early and get a recording session. Or not really a session, but at least a video in for Friday. Hopefully. I didn't really think about that before. That kind of sucks. After work. Anyways, yeah. So, DiRT 4. Get hyped for that. Hyped as you want to be. And, of course, like I said, DiRT 1 and then DiRT 2. I will have a video of the day after this, which tomorrow. I don't know why I said the day after. And then, of course, DiRT 3 to round it off, which I managed to break today by trying to set it up to record it first. Hopefully, I'll be able to get it fixed by the day that I want to record it, but if not, I don't know what I'm going to do. I think I have it on Xbox, if anything. This game is a ton of fun, though. I'm generally I don't know if it's nostalgia still, or if it's actually a better game, like this game is a better game than the latter two. Although I didn't really like DiRT 2 that much, just because of the lack of rally content. It was like, oh, X Games, Mountain Dew, Monster, crap, energy drinks, stadiums, yeah, that kind of stuff. I've already won. I wasn't a big fan of that, so I liked this game a lot more than that, because this game has mostly, well, pretty much all actual rallies. There's Rallycross, and that's about it, but it's like legit Rallycross. It's not like, let's put Monster in your veins. I don't know what I'm saying. Yeah, and DiRT 3 kind of went back to it, and DiRT Rally really went back to it, but I haven't played enough of DiRT Rally, and DiRT 3 is just, I don't know. I'm not the biggest fan of it. Because, like, the only thing that this game is really missing out compared to DiRT 3, and even DiRT Rally, is the graphics. Although DiRT Rally, the physics, I don't really know what to think about the physics on it. Just because of the fact that I could never get them at all. I sucked and ran off the road all the time whenever I played DiRT Rally for, like, the 2 hours I've played it since I bought it 2 years ago, I think it was. Yeah. But anyways, I won that, so we're going to head on to another race series here, which we are going to be using SUVs of sorts. And I kind of want to buy a lever again, but I'm not going to because I don't want to spend my money. And let's go to, what is this called again? It's not Land Rush. That's in the newer games. T1 Raid, I think it is, because there's like T1 Raid and there's like T4 Raid, which is like the fucking gigantic trucks. Which is also really fun as well. Yeah. This. Oh my god, I keep pressing the wrong button to shift up, because it's... So the dumb thing is that on the PC version of this game, I don't know if you can on the Xbox version, but on the PC version, it recognizes the Xbox controller, and it's like, oh, it's an Xbox controller, and here's the control setup. But, like, you can't change the control... Oh, for Jesus. Oh my god. You can't change... Oh, I just really fucked my car. You can't change the controls, so I'm stuck with A to shift up and X to shift down, which I am definitely not used to. I'm used to X to shift down as it is, but I'm used to B shifting up, or at least, you know, X shifting up. Okay, this is not going to work. Yeah, I'm used to either X and B or X and A switch from what it is in this game. Because it makes sense, because, like, it's more, X is more up than A, but I don't know. Oh, you son of a fuck. I hate everything. I'm having issues. Also, I love the instant restarts. There's no loading times whenever you restart in this game. It's fantastic. Okay, I'm gonna stay, like, way the fuck over here so you guys don't touch me at all. If you touch me, you're gonna be a fucking ding-dong. It's Grandma, get off the road. Get out of the way. Oh no, this is bad because there's rocks over here. I'm live, and it's not going to reset me. Wow, I thought it was going to reset me, because a lot of times if you cut the course, it'll reset your ass. It's like, nope, you cheated, therefore you get to get reset. And I'm glad I didn't hit a rock, too, because there's a lot of rocks to hit on this track, map, road thing. Oh god, I keep pressing the wrong button even though I... literally like, oh, that's this button, I'm talking about it, and I'm like, oh, this is stupid, but then I continue to, I guess that's why it's stupid, because I continue to be stupid with it. Or I'm the stupid and the controls aren't. Something like that. I don't really know. I guess it's... No, I don't know. I would almost say it's better than Need for Speed right stick shifting, where you push forward on the right stick to shift up and back to shift down, which is very strange. Which I actually used in the crew, now I think about it, for my playthrough. I used that control setup because I wanted to use all the other buttons for something else. But yeah, I think switching A and X is worse. Because, like, I can remember that, you know, forward is shift up, back is shift down. In this, it's like, oh, you remember those games that you play where X was shift up? Ha, guess what? We changed it. Why am I ranting about buttons? Anyways, yes, this is a Mitsubishi, by the way. Of some sort. It's an L200, I think, which is basically a Montero, I think. It's missing part of its roof. I don't know if it's actually supposed to be like that or if it's, you know, a truck. I've never actually seen a thing like this in person or in images, I don't even think. Oh my god, big jumps. So, yeah. I have a co-driver. Which is very not helpful in this game. Just a coworker. I said coworker, damn it. Co-driver, not co-worker. He's not very useful because he doesn't really say much. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Oh my god. Oh, I almost died. I saw my life flash in my eyes. On a random note, the physics of this game are pretty fantastic for being from 2006. Like, I've played a lot of rally games, and this game has one of the best physics. Well, it's a good blend of realistic versus arcade, I guess. Because, of course, Rally Sport Challenge 2 has a really fun arcade-y feeling to it, but it's very arcade-y. This game tends to be a little bit more realistic. A little bit, not much. And I think I like it better than Rally Sport Challenge 2, honestly. Especially since there's so many different vehicles to drive, and some of them are like 30 feet tall, like I said, those big-ass trucks. Do I have any of those unlocked? I don't think I do, do I? I'm probably gonna have to buy a truck for it. Let's see, front-wheel drive. No. Let's go over here. Is there anything over here that's good? Nope, I don't have anything open. Let's do something different. Let's do hill climb all-wheel drive, because I've done front-wheel drive stuff. I think I'll pick the Subaru. I usually pick the Mitsubishi, I think. I can't remember, but I think Subaru has a lot less power than the Evo. The only thing the Evo has is that it's got a shorter wheelbase. Whatever, I'll buy the Imprezel. Imprezel! The Hawkeye, as they call it. Save process complete. And, I say Colin McRae because blue, but it's probably, Colin McRae raced these. This was the last Subaru they raced, honestly, I think. But I don't think that's it might be a Colin McRae driven, oh, that's Colin McRae, I'm fucking stupid. I'm pretty sure that's Colin McRae there. But yeah, still blue, and it costs less, so whatever. Let's go! I've driven 11.61 miles in this game. And it's funny, because on the Xbox, there's achievements for driving thousands of miles in this game. And if you complete the career, you drive less than 1,000 miles. And I think there's one for 5,000. So basically, good luck on getting those achievements. Although, if you're, like, really bored and have nothing else to do, I'm sure it wouldn't be that hard. Just, you know, continuously pick a track or something and drive on it. That's something I would have done whenever I was about 12 or 13. Because I was a very sad individual in middle school and did nothing but play video games. And I probably honestly did that in games that weren't this game. I don't know, I didn't play this game much originally. I didn't play it much until I did my playthrough on it, believe it or not. And that was my first big exposure, or like, long time exposure to this game. And during that playthrough, I developed quite a fondness of it. As I've mentioned. Oh my god, I'm almost dying. Oh god, oh yeah, this game has many views as well. There we go, that's the button right. That's the button right, yes, that's English as well. Let's go for interior view for a bit. Usually I don't because it's not that bad in this game, honestly. Rally Sport Challenge 2, the interior view is a pain in the ass. because you can't see anything. And there, well, I think that it has the heads-up display on still, which this game it doesn't. I just realized. But you can't see like any of the gauges or any steering wheel, or I'm dead. Oh, I can't reset my vehicle. Oh, there we go. Cool. That's how you do it. You let the game do it for you. This game is actually the graphics have held up very, very well for being over 10 years old now. Especially on PC, because I'm like, you know, running at max settings, 1440p. Things that this game was not originally supposed to run in. Although this game is a very big pain in the ass to run as well. Like, if you don't have a pretty beefy computer, you won't be able to get 60 frames per second at the highest settings on 1080p. Like, unless you have a really beefy computer. And this, like I said, this game came out in 2006, or maybe 2007 for PC, I can't remember. And it's like just a giant pain to run for some reason. Winner, winner, child. Is there another race in this? I don't think there is. Nope. Yeah, it starts out very simple. It's like, oh, these races are short because, hey, we're letting you learn the game. Hey, I have things unlocked. Do we have anything new? Anything interesting? I don't think so. I see an interesting one. I'm just going to kind of do these out of order because, you know, I want to do different stuff in this video. Subaru. Do I want to do another Subaru? I've used a Celica so much. I think I have used a Celica so much. I can't remember. Oh, I don't know if I want the Subaru or the Celica. It doesn't really matter because I can purchase both of them. Actually, yeah, I can. I can actually purchase both of these at the same time. I don't know which one I want. Which one's better power-wise? The Celica is. Beck, I'm going to go with the Celica. Sorry. I wanted the GC8, but, you know, Celica. I like Celicas, especially these Celicas. I was actually thinking about buying one of these somewhat recently. See anything interesting here? I don't care, I'm buying this. This reminds me of what game? I guess it was Gran Turismo 5 that I played that had this car with this livery in it. That sounds right. Yeah, because it was a premium car. Yeah. As well as probably like other games, but I can't remember them off the top of my head. But yeah, I was actually like looking at Craigslist at I think it was a 94. It was like this generation of Celica, and it was all original, 5-speed manual, in fairly good condition, and not too high miles, like 120,000 miles or something. So I was like, man, I'd like that, but then I was like, oh yeah, my truck actually still runs and drives perfectly fine, and that doesn't require me to spend, oh my god, tires. Yeah, that would have required me to spend, you know, an extra, like, $2,000, because they wanted, like, $4,500 to $5,000 for it, and my truck's not worth nearly that much. So that would have been a slight, oh god, tires. That would have been a slight setback. If you've got that corner back there, you get reset. I need to change my view because I messed it up. I just saw clipping. I clipped through the, oh god, the roof of the car. Ah, excuse me. I need to speed up, because, you know, rallycross, short races. It's too, oh, for fuck, okay. I'm good, I'm alive somehow. I'm having issues with staying on the track. It's a slight problem. Oh god. Oh, excuse me. Oh, I keep pressing the wrong button to look back. Fuck. Oh, I made a traffic jam. Cool. I used somebody else to make a traffic jam. Nice. Okay, getting in front of you. It's rallycross. It's dirty, rubbing his race, and I'm like, I think Dale Earnhardt? Senior? I think said that? I don't know. I need to pass this other Celica as soon as possible, please. Oh my god, I hit things. There's things to hit. Excuse me, sir. Would you like to hear about our Lord and Savior Celica? Well, you're driving Celica. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna get reset. Oh, I didn't get reset. Oh, get fucked. I was saying something. Relaying the Celicas in my truck and stuff, but I don't remember what those things were. So we're just gonna improvise from here on out. Ah! You don't have enough speed. Suck my ass. Oh, I pressed the wrong button again. Damn it. I can't change my view anymore. So that has been DiRT on the PC. Pretty fun game. I would definitely recommend it to anybody. I would probably recommend getting on, you know, Xbox or PS3 if you don't, like I said, if you don't have a beefy computer, or if you have like Windows 8 on a computer still. Sorry, I'm dying because there's crap stuck in my throat. But if you do have a beefy Windows 10 PC and you can find a disc of this, that would be fantastic. And or you can get on, you know, PS3 or Xbox 360. And it's still good. It just runs at 20 frames per second and looks like poo. But that has been the game. So as I mentioned, we'll be back with DiRT 2 tomorrow. And thank you all for watching. And I'm out of here. See ya.